Hello everyone, my name is Gisung Kim. I'm from NSL in Korea. In this session, I'm going to talk about Dynamic Searchable Symmetry Encryption Scheme. I will call it SSE scheme. And I will explain how to make update efficient in Ford secure SSE schemes. This is joint work with Mingyu Kim, Dong Suri, Jeong Park, Wang Kim. They're also from NSL in Korea. Let's begin with the introduction of SSE schemes. The cloud storage services like Google Drive, whose purpose is to manage user data, are becoming common. The problem is that the user-sensitive data is stored in the untrusted cloud server. So we know that the basic approach for protecting the user data is encrypt them using general symmetric encryption schemes like AES. However, the semantic securities of these schemes destroys any ability to perform useful operation, even basic search operation on the encrypted data. So the decryption is the only way to get some useful information on the encrypted data. So SSE, searchable symmetric encryption scheme, can be a partial solution of this problem. It is a cryptographic technique that enables a client to perform efficient keyword search. Keyword search means a searching document containing a specific keyword on the encrypted data. This picture shows how the SSE scheme works. There are two parties, client and server. DB is a set of documents, and W means a keyword. From this example, we can know that the ID1 is an identifier of document D1, and D1 contains W124 as a keyword. From this information, we can construct the following matrix-type data structure called index. If this index is stored in the server side, then client can update or search documents very efficiently. So we can think SSE scheme as how to encrypt this index part searchable and securely. There are two different ways constructing an index. The first one is called Ford index. It is based on a document. So for each ID, the set of keywords that each document contains is stored. So in this type of index can support very efficient update operation by adding or deleting a row. But how to search document is not straightforward. And the second method is called inverted index. It is based on keyword. So for each keyword, the set of ID containing the keyword is stored. So the inverted index can support very efficient search operation. Each row implies a search result of each keyword, but the updating document is not a simple problem in this type of index. Okay, when we measure the efficiency of SSE schemes, we should consider the following three complexities: computational and storage and communication. We can know that easily what they mean, so I will skip the details. And when we prove the security of SSE schemes, we first define leakage functions of each queries. L1 means information leakage when updating documents, and L2 means search leakage. And then we should show that all transcript of real protocol, this part, each queries can be chosen by an attacker adaptively, and we should show that this part can be simulated with only L1, L2 leakage. Okay. So we can think that this security model ensures that the underlying SSE scheme does not reveal any information beyond defined L1, L2 leakage. This is how to prove the security of SSE schemes. And let's take a look at the notion of forward security in SSE schemes. This is a simple construction on the inverted index. For each keyword, the documents that containing the keyword are encrypted with secret keys. These keys can be computed from the same colored search token. In this example, client generates the addition token of W1, and send it to server, then server can decrypt this red part, and he can return the encryption of D1, D4, D2 as a search result. Okay, and then the client store another document D7 that contains W1. At this time, the server can try to search operation again with the same previous rebuild search token. If the underlying scheme is forward secure, that means a server should know if D7 contains W1. So we can think the forward security is newly updated document. Don't reveal any keyword information from the previous rebuild search tokens. This is the notion of forward security. And recently in Ingenuity 16, the file injection attack has been proposed. The author shows that it was possible to rebuild the plain text keyword information from the past search tokens by only a few document injection, if the underlying SSE scheme cannot guarantee the forward security. So this is the simple example of file injection attack. It is quite simple and popular attack on SSE schemes. And so since then, when you design a new SSE scheme, this security should be considered. Okay. I will skip the details of this attack. And let's review some previous forward secure schemes. We focused on the following two forward secure schemes. In particular, the schemes called SOPOS, presented in C16, shows the best performance compared to the previous forward secure schemes. So we wanted to improve their efficiency without any loss of security. This is a simple dictionary data structure. As you know, it is one of the well-known data structure, and it consists of label and value pairs. And this value can be controlled by label as an address within constant time. So many previous schemes used this data structure to maximize their performance. And the previous scheme also chose the inverted index data structure because they want to take advantage of the best search time. But there is an updating problem in the inverted index. So in the previous scheme, the inefficiency problem of adding document has been solved by maintaining keyword counter information at the client side. I will explain this using this simple example. And the following example shows the, how the previous scheme works conceptually. It's not exact description, only conceptual idea. And TW means a trapdoor of keyword, and TID is a trapdoor of ID. And this example, how to generate the addition token of document 3 that contains W2 and W3. At first, the client have to find out the counter information of W2 and W3 in his state. Okay? The client have to maintain this state to insert document efficiently. For example, the counter information is 1 of keyword 2. This means that the ID 3, document 3, is the first document that contains W2. And this is the encrypted index that is stored in the dictionary data structure at the server side. A label is a hash value of a TW and counter number. And value part is encryption of ID. And TW is used as a secret keys of this encryption scheme. However, it seems that the previous forward secure scheme have not found appropriate answers for the deletion operation. In their scheme, the deletion operation was supported by duplicating the data structure. This means that there are two learning instances. One is for the addition, and another is for the deletion part. And so in this example, client wants to delete document D1 in EDB. This operation is performed as the addition operation into the deletion instance. You can think this is another server, deletion server. So the EDB size is getting larger with the number of updates. And this is a search process. TWR is used as a search token of each keyword. After receiving the TW from the client, the server can compute these three tuples by increasing counter number. And he can also decrypt this value part because he knows the TW1. So, and this process also should be done in deletion instance 2. Okay? And then the server will return the difference between two search results. So it costs the degrading ability in terms of server storage and the search time because the deleted information should be maintained in the server. And the server have to search some information in addition part and deletion part at the same time. So the search time can be measured as AW plus DW. AW means the length of this part, the number of documents that contains W1. And DW can be defined similar way. And this table summarizes the efficiency of a previous forward secure scheme, in particular the SOPOS presented in C16, because they show the best performance. Okay, the search time and EDB size are worse than the optimal case. And we know that it is caused by the incomplete deletion operation. So we wanted to do most in our work is to design a new forward secure schemes that can support optimal deletion operation. So we wanted to these two inefficiency factors without any loss of security. Okay. From now on, I'll introduce our new proposed scheme. It started from a simple idea. It is possible to design a new index which takes all advantages of both forward and inverted index. We will call it a dual index. And this is an example of inverted index data structure. I have already explained how to generate the addition token of in this type of index. And there is a counter number 2. And this counter number can be counted from TW3. And 2 means this is the second document that contains W3. And this is a forward index data structure. In this type of data structure, the label is computed as a hash value of TID, not TW. And another counter number, 2, has been used. Okay? This 2 means this part is a second keyword part in document 3. And we wanted to this forward index data structure to this inverted index data structure. So like this. Then we can check there exist two different type of index on single dual index. And we also wanted to use dictionary data structure because we didn't want any loss of performance. So we thought that this could be possible if we could construct a new dictionary data structure that has two labels with one value, like this. Then label 1 and value can be from the forward index, and label 2 and value is used as an inverted index. And this is our dual dictionary data structure. There are two labels and only one value, and this type of dictionary data structure can be constructed easily by linking two different single dictionary data structure, like this. Label 1 and label 2, this pair is stored in a single dictionary data structure. And label 2 and this pair, label 1 and value, can be used as a value part of label 2. Okay? This new second pair is stored in another single dictionary data structure. Then this value can be controlled by label 1, like this, and also label 2 directly. And it's also within constant time. But the storage size is 2 times bigger, larger than the single dictionary data structure. And this is an example of SSE construction on our dual index. I have already explained how to generate the addition token in this type of index. And note that the client have to still maintain the keyword count information to add insert document efficiently. This is the state. And the deletion operation can be performed efficiently by computing the label one. And TID1 is used as a deletion token of document T1. After receiving the TID1, then the server can compute these two tuples by increasing counter number in label one. And he can delete these two tuples in EDB. And this type of deletion operation has two advantages compared to the previous deletion operation. The first one is the client don't need to know all keywords contained in the document to be deleted. The ID is the only information that the client have to know before deleting the document. And we can assume that the same document is deleted repeatedly by certain error, maybe. Then there is no problem in our case. But in the previous scheme, the meaningless data, meaningless document are continually added to EDB deletion instance. And the search process is the same way as the inverted index. So the TW is used as a search token and is sent it to server. Then server can compute these three red-colored tuples, okay, 1, 2, 3. And we know that the first tuple has been deleted in the previous slide. So, but the server have to search this part because there is a counter number one. Okay, so we know that during the search process, the server knows that the deleted document D1 contained this searched keyword. This is a very meaningful information leakage. So this type of leakage can be defined as a backward security in some previous works. So our scheme cannot guarantee the backward security. And the search time can be measured only AW. There is no plus DW term because we don't need to maintain the deleted information. But this is still not optimal search time because the deleted part should be searched during the search process. Okay, this is the main idea for better search time and the forward security. Our scheme used Lee encryption and secret key switching technique. And I will explain these two techniques using this simple picture. This is an encrypted index of each keyword. And this can be divided into two parts. Part A, previously searched part that is encrypted with key 1. And part B is newly added part B that is encrypted with key 2. And there might be some deleted information part A and B. During the search operation, the server decrypt part A and B and return the search result to the client. And then after that, the server re-encrypt part A and B together, except the deleted information with another fresh key 3. So the deleted information will never be searched again. So this is how to achieve the better search time. Okay, and the another key 4, should be prepared for the newly added document in the future. So key 1 switched into key 3 and key 2 switched into key 4. This is a secret key switching. And we can check that secret keys are always updated whenever the search operation is performed. So this is how to guarantee the forward security in our scheme. And this is the efficiency analysis of our scheme. So the search time and EDB size have been improved by supporting the optimal deletion operation. The EDB size is optimal and the search time only 8W, but it is still not optimal. And this is security analysis of our scheme. Updated leakage is only identifier and the number of keyword on the updated document. And the search leakage consists of following two information leakage, a search pattern, and a list of IDs historically added to EDB of each keyword. The important thing is this leakage level is the same as the previous our target to for the secure schemes. Okay, this is the implementation result. We used the unknown email data set, and this is our target implementation is SOPOS, and we could obtain an open source code in GitLab. And okay, this table shows the main internal computation or main internal function in SOPOS and our case. T means trapdoor permutation, and H means hash function. F is a pseudonym function. So, in SOPOS, they used the trapdoor permutation to guarantee the forward security, and it was implemented as a RSA operation. So, as you know, it is quite heavier than hash function, but in our case, we used only hash function and pseudonym function. And this is the test result, the EDB creation performance. This is a bulk insertion of whole email data set into the server. So this is the test result. Our scheme has less CPU time and less client storage space. Okay. Okay. It is from the RSA operation, but the EDB size is 2 times larger than the SOPOS because we use the dual dictionary data structure. And this is the update and search performance. We checked the change of EDB size. This graph shows that, and the search time by repeatedly updating 10 randomly chosen documents. Okay, the SOPOS, the gray colored part and the gray colored line. You can check that increase linearly with the number of updates. This is quite a trivial result. It is from the incomplete deletion operation. But in our case, and this part and this graph shows the are stable. We can check that these two factors are stable. Okay, this is what I prepared, and you may have noticed my English is not so good. So if you have any question, you can email me or we can meet after this session with our team. Thank you for your attention. Thank you.